All right, guys, we're just gonna explore a few different ways of dealing with the spider guy. It's gonna be, someone's good at the spider guy, it's gonna be one of the most frustrating guys to deal with. And we'll deal with the feet on the biceps, but also the lasso guy as well, for a reason, because he's like over the top, like this, okay? So, we're reaching over the top, grabbing the pants here like this, elbows tight, and I can, when I've got here like this, when I walk backwards, I can start to release the pressure of Michael's legs, okay? From there, I can just push down and clear the grips, just like that. Again, my reaching over the top of the shin, grabbing the inside of the pants, elbows tight, walk back, and punch down. Generally, in spider guard, if I can keep back, I wanna keep back on my own base. So when Michael's moving around, I generally tend to wanna like stay back here. It's making him sit up, it loses some of his power with his hips. The worst thing you can do is start like giving them a chance now. When he extends, he moves my body and moves me around. So I actually wanna like pull him up and stay back here. It's hard for him to sweep here. I can start clearing grips, okay? We did both at once, but you can just do one. Okay, next one. If that's not working, I can circle my hand to the inside, turn my hips to face to the side, lift the hand, and then face away and grip the shin like this. Don't grab the pants, because you grab the pants, sometimes they'll swim their foot back in and recover. So I wanna go hand inside, have to face away for this, open up, and then I face back the other way and I grip the shin. Recover that now, because it's on the shin, and I should block. Once that one's done, I'm now facing my right. I swing my hand inside, so forearm behind the Achilles. I lift up as I turn out, and I got the other shin. That sets up, ready to pass. Sometimes they straighten their leg, like this, okay? When they straighten their leg, you have to usually focus on this one first. So I'm gonna walk across, and I'm gonna bend it by putting my opposite shin, in front of the knee, and I bring my elbow back. Okay, then we have a chance to circle underneath, just like we did with the last one. Once more, it straightens that leg, come across, and we can circle inside. Another really nice one. If they've got too much, let's say that doesn't work, so go again. This, I just can't bend the knee. Let's walk around here. What I can do, I lean away, and I'm actually gonna put my right knee just below the kneecap here to catch the heel, and I'm gonna bring my elbow back. The aim is like, I'm taking enough tension off that it's not really tight on my elbow, so I can do this. I just bring my elbow behind my knee. Now that's gone, I can circle. Let's have a look again. So we'll go straight, we'll go out to here, and we plop that in. All right. We can go behind the calf like this. So let's say I try to push the legs down, his knees are bent, push down, it's not working. I try to circle underneath, it's not working. I can change both hands underneath, get my hips low, and I pop my hips forward, pushing into the calf to stack, okay? From there, we can work into some leg drags. All right, now let's have a look at the lasso. There's basically, to me, there's two ways of dealing with the lasso. The lasso comes over the top. The first way is we circle our hand. So as soon as they go for it, you want to circle your hand. Once more, my hand goes behind the knee. Now, I don't like to grip, because when I grip, it allows, like I don't pressure, he can stay facing me with this knee. What I like to do is actually like, so keep hold of the grip, Michael. I keep my hand punching down. So there's actually a weight, pressuring him away, so it's hard for him to turn in. If he keeps hold of that grip, while I'm doing that, I circle off the spider guard, and when I go to pass, this same weighted pressure is gonna turn his hips away, just from that pressure, okay? Whereas when I'm holding onto the leg, he turns in enough, and I come around now, kick your knee in front, now it's hard to like pass. So I want that straight, and extending like that. What that looks like in real time, Leandro Lowe's very good at this, but as he goes to circle the lasso, we go through and we're dropping our weight in straight away. As soon as we're circling, we're getting around the corner and dropping our weight. That's one way to deal with the lasso, is circling the hand.
If they're a little bit more tricky with that, so go over. If they're, let's say, I feel like I still might be able to circle, but I want to get my right knee behind the near leg. I sit back. That's going to allow me to circle my hand. If there's a bit more distance, like I was saying before, I often don't want to commit my weight to him. And when here he's got the lasso, I can often kick with my foot just to circle, keep hold of that. There you go. Love holding on, but once it's out there, same pressure, we can pass. All right, apart from circling, we can try and circle their leg out as well. So, Lucas Leckley, very good at this stuff. I like to anchor my hand. So I can't free my hand now, I'll anchor it. I like to grab the collar. Some people like to grab the belt, either one's fine. And try and push his foot back in and square it out. So I'm gonna sit him up by walking backwards, like this. Have a look, come around this side. My right knee is gonna get to his toe. So I'm in like a full deep squat knee here. He can't triangle me because I'm like seated back and my elbows are tight. I'm gonna catch his knee, I might catch my knee on his toes. And I push his foot inwards like this. What's the danger here is that he pummels it back through. So I'm gonna try and stack him. I'm gonna flare my elbow. Actually, I need to clear this too, sorry. So just like a normal spider, I'm gonna clear that. And I'm gonna walk to the side with my elbow, using that and my knee to stack him here like this. You see that the lasso's gone, but just say he's trying to keep the lasso foot in front. Sometimes people are like this if they really love their lasso. I'm gonna pummel my head underneath now. Now there's no lasso, and then walk to the side and pass. Once more quick, and then that's it for our series. So Michael's got a tight lasso. Obviously, we can clear this first, that's great. Sit back, free the foot, drop, and pressure until we stack them, okay? Head goes in so they can't re-lasso, and we cover it down. And pass the other.